Hey guys, namaste, this is Nehal, and once more you are most welcome to my channel at Crazy for Veggie. Now if you are already subscribed to my YouTube channel, that you definitely know that I am a pizza maniac. So today I'm going to make the Shahi paneer pizza. Now I do enjoy Indian flavor in my pizza so much, so I always try and experimenting the different flavors in my pizza. So yeah, it's a pretty simple and easy and tasty pizza recipe. So now let's see how to make our Shahi paneer pizza. So now let's start to knead our pizza dough. Here I have dry active yeast, and this is my 1 cup of warm water. You make sure you have the warm water. So add about a teaspoon of the yeast and add about a teaspoon of sugar and just mix it well. Sugar helps to active your yeast very nicely. And we have to let it rest for like 10 minutes. And now in the flour, I'm adding salt and olive oil. And now you can see that yeast is bubbly. You can see it's activated. Add this into the flour and simply, mix this with wooden spatula first, because it will be super sticky. So your hands can get messy. Once you little bit mix it, you can use your hands and start mixing it. Now don't expect it to be like chapati dough. It will be super sticky, so add little bit of oil and try to get rid of the the sticky dough from your hands. Now cover your vessel with plastic wrap or cloth, anything, and let your dough rise for like next 1 or 1.5 hours. Meanwhile, let's marinate our paneer. So here I have paneer cubes, and over here I have the spices like the red chili powder, coriander and cumin powder, garam masala, kitchen king masala and turmeric powder. Along with that I have some yogurt, some oil and salt. So in my paneer cubes I am adding all those masalas into it. Adding about like 2 to 3 tablespoons of yogurt, salt as per the taste, and little bit of the oil, about like 1/2 teaspoon. And you have to make sure that you cube the paneer finely, like the small baby chunks of paneer. You don't need the big bites of the paneer. Now let it wait for around like 1 hour. Let them marinate until our pizza dough is also rusty, and then we will move forward. After 1 hour, you can see that my dough is almost risen like in a double of the size. So take it out in any flat surface and add a little bit of the flour and knead it for a while. Though don't expect it to be like smooth, it will be super sticky. I try to add it like more water this time than the usually I add, but the more sticky dough, my pizza base came out so well. So even though it will give a little bit of huddle while you are rolling your pizza, but your pizza at the end, it will come out really good. So knead it for a while and make 2 balls out of it. So it will make like the 10 each pizza each. So I'm going to make the 2 pizza. So I'm going to use 1/2 of the dough right now. And in my pizza pan, I have added like olive oil. And you can see that dough is quite sticky. So on top of that also, I'm going to apply like lots of olive oil. And by that, you are able to roll the pizza because the flour will not work here. So drizzle some oil on the top. And yeah, also, sprinkle some suji or some corn flour at the bottom along with the olive oil. It will help pizza to stick to its place rather than, shrinking inside. So yeah, as you can see, it's shrinking inside. So it's giving me a little hard time to roll. So as I done rolling my pizza, over here I have the toppings. So green bell pepper, red onions, green onions and cilantro. These both are after bake option. And this is my marinated paneer, which is resting for about like 1 hour. And this is my homemade Indo-Italian pizza sauce. Now this is the must if you are making my mango chaat pizza or this Shahi paneer pizza or any Indianized pizza, because it has a hint of the Indian spices. So if you want to see the recipe of it, click here. Now I'm going to add generous amount of mozzarella cheese on top of that, and just leave little edge plain while you are spreading the pizza sauce. Now goes my toppings. So here is a green bell pepper, red onion, and finally our marinated paneer. So from that much paneer you can make a two pizza. So half of the paneer I'm going to use right now, and remaining I will going to use on my next pizza. And yeah, my oven is already preheated at 450. So now this pizza will go into the bottom rack of the oven for around like 5 to 10 minutes, depending upon your oven. So check after 5 minutes, and if it is completely at the bottom, your pizza is ready. And here we are, my pizza is ready, and after that I sprinkle green onion and the cilantro on the top. Pardon my voice, I am a bit sick today because of cold and cough. So I'm now cutting it, and believe me, this is the best pizza I ever had, and so my friends ever had, whosoever tried this, they say this is the best Indian pizza which they tasted, even better than the restaurant style. Oh, what else you need? Do give a try to this twist and enjoy. Hey guys, so that's it for my today's session. That was a recipe of a Shahi paneer pizza. Now don't forget to try this recipe, because you and your family will definitely going to love this. Stay tuned, because so many recipes are there on their way. I will see you soon in my next recipe. Till then, take care. Bye bye.